Bashar.
Andrew, you good guy?
How are you?
Perfect, and you?
Good. I actually brought a little show and tell.
Oh, all right.
And I found something very synchronistic about
guys,
today.
Yes.
We were just talking about free energy, and
yes.
We were talking last public channeling about a double helix cone
yes.
fitting into itself.
Yes.
And
you have begun to experiment.
Yes, I've begun to experiment and actually brought one. I just received this. I had a model made.
Yes.
A couple of days ago. I just received it.
Yes.
A couple of days ago. And I'll hold it up so everybody can see it. It's just a cone with a kind of a spiral around it.
Yes.
And I had a computer model this and then a machine actually make this.
Yes. Well, this is the template for the construction of the conductive material.
Exactly. This is a jig that I wrap a coil around.
Yes.
And so I've done that. I just did this yesterday, the day before yesterday.
Oh, all right.
And it's basically two coils kind
yes.
of spun into each other.
Yes.
Exactly as you were describing.
Yes. Well, not exactly because they're not insulated yet.
That's correct. And, in fact, I bought the insulating paint the day before yesterday, so
oh,
that's
like
my next step. But I find the synchronicity so interesting because I've been working on this kind of on and off for the past several months. And just day before yesterday, I received it in the mail.
Yes.
So
thank you for your synchronicity.
Hours later, I wrap this thing together, and the next day I'm showing up here at the talent. So
and there you go.
It's so interesting.
Yes.
So my question for you, and
yes.
I don't want to get too technical now. I will at a private. But my question for you is basically, how does this thing work? What is it? What is it doing? What am I? Okay, so I've got these coils. They're wrapped into each other.
It is, in some degree, the essence of what you call a capacitor and a transformer.
Okay.
The idea is that once you initiate a certain kind of electrical current through it, you allow it to become vibrationally sensitive because of its shape to higher frequency energies, which are then, in a sense, harmonically attracted to it and begin coursing along the same route. Once the higher frequency energies begin coursing along the same route, it sets up a self-reinforcing vibration that then can be amplified in a variety of ways and transformed, stepped down, and transformed into electrical energy or various kinds of energy that you can tap and use for your devices on your planet.
Okay, so basically I need to kickstart it with a pulse, an AC pulse, or
yes.
a DC current, probably an AC pulse.
Yes.
And then it'll start resonating.
Yes.
And it will, in a sense, drive itself.
Yes.
From which I can then start tapping energy off of it.
Yes. Now, this is the very beginning.
I know. This
and
is
the
very
early experimentational form. This will improve and this will become more sophisticated. But first, it is necessary to do the experimentations at this level in order to then see that you're getting some effect, which will then guide you to the next stage of refining it.
On that note, there are actually quite a number of inventors out there that have devices that
yes.
are at the very beginning stages
yes.
that actually show anomalous, quote-unquote anomalous,
yes.
energy being generated. It's
yes.
already out there. That
yes.
This stuff already exists.
Yes, I know.
And they're still, they're in the basic stages, so they're figuring things out.
Yes.
Just like I am, I'm
yes.
sorry, you know.
Yes.
So,
and this is the Esasani approach.
Ah, got it. Okay, then what? One last question on this. What is then the energy that it's resonating with? You said a higher frequency energy?
Yes.
From what? Or describe that more. What energy? Energy from what?
Well, it's from what have been euphemistically referred to as the template level reality.
Ah, I get it.
Or what sometimes...
Astral plane?
Lower astral plane might be another euphemism for it, yes.
I'm going to use that word again. That's cool.
All right. Thank you.
You do understand what that means, right?
Of course.
Okay, good. It's not that we're freezing down here. It's just things are cool.
Yes.
I guess that's it.
Thank you. Enjoy your experimentation.
I am looking forward to it very much.
We are looking backward to it.
I bet you are. I love you, Bashar.
Our love to you as well.